Hello everyone. This video is about directivity of an antenna array. Directivity is somewhat similar to gain of an antenna. Let's recall what we have learned from the last lectures. In the last lectures, we talk about intensity and we try to work out the L phase and normalize the intensity. And the formula that we have got is here. The average and normalized intensity is given by pi divided by nkd. And the n is the number of elements in the array. And d is the physical distance between two labeling elements. And k is 2 pi divided by lambda. And now we try to work out the directivity. And remember, directivity is given by U is the intensity. And then U naught is the L phase intensity. So we better write this down, right? Where U is the intensity. And U naught is the L phase intensity. And we know that the maximum directivity is going to be the U maximum with the maximum intensity. Yeah, normally the maximum intensity can find in the major loop. And then if we divide the top and bottom by the maximum, and what we will get here, the upper expression will be 1, the lower expression will be n. It's a normalized and L phase intensity. So what we can do is we can use this formula here, and what we are going to get is k nkd divided by pi. And remember the value of k is actually 2 pi divided by lambda. So nd and then 2 pi divided by lambda and then pi. And if you work out this expression carefully, you will get the length of an antenna array. So for instance, you have an n element, right? In this case, n is equal to 5. But the spacing is actually 4. So the length of the antenna is n minus 1. So let L be the total length of the array. Yeah, counting. Yeah, this is the length. And L, according to here, is given by n minus 2 times d. And if the array is large, this means if n is large, then n is equal to this one, and L is equal to nd. So if this is the case, then we can for sure approximate the maximum directivity as what? 2L divided by lambda. Now the next thing that we are trying to do is to assume lambda as pi divided by 2. So this is a special case. So if lambda is, if d is equal to lambda divided by 2, then according to the equation here, it is going to be d max is equal to n. So I hope it is clear enough for you guys. If you have any questions, please leave your questions to the comments box. Thank you very much for your attending this lecture. Bye-bye.